卡蒂教授对南海问题的研究始于2009年，当时南海问题因为有关争端当事国的侵权挑衅加剧而有所升温。在香港任教的卡蒂于暑假回国期间，在英国国家档案馆发现有大量档案直接涉及南沙群岛的归属问题。这之后，他把南海问题作为一项重要的研究工作，跑遍英国、法国和美国的档案馆，查阅了大量19世纪末以来有关南海诸岛所有权问题的档案。卡蒂认为中国对南海诸岛的主权有充分的历史和法理依据，菲律宾对南沙群岛没有任何可信的主权主张。
Archival material from the British and the French foreign ministries, the work of the legal advisors I've explored over about 100 years, and they have repeatedly considered the question of the Nansha and the Shisha Islands. They are applying the Western standards of international law.And they come to the conclusion that China is the owner of these islands. There are pretty categorical statements by both the British and the French, and even the Americans, that the Filipinos have no claim whatsoever to any territory, shoals, reefs, or whatever, in the South China Sea.The British also, in their memorandum of 1974, a formal memorandum of the legal department, they reached the conclusion that the Spratlys were Chinese and no longer French and had never been Filipino. And that was a position accepted by the Foreign Affairs, the Defense and Overseas Committee of the British Cabinet.Also, the American State Department archive, which is public, indicated in 1956 that the Americans had no views about any Filipino claim, but they considered that it could be in their strategic interest to encourage the Filipinos to make claims. So they put the Filipinos up to it.
菲律宾近期频频提及所谓南海仲裁案裁决，将其作为一系列单边侵权活动的法律依据。而上周美日菲三边峰会发表的声明则呼吁中国遵守这一所谓的裁决。卡蒂指出，一些域外国家无视历史与事实，鼓励菲律宾提出领土主张，背后充满对自身战略利益的考量。所谓的南海仲裁案裁决正是某些国家假国际法之名谋取私欲。
The arbitration supports the Philippines. It says that the islands are not entitledto any maritime zone, and that therefore the Philippines are entitled to claim a 200-mile economic zone extended from the western coast of the Philippines right into the middle of the South China Sea, excluding China completely. And then Vietnam would come from the other side of the South China Sea, moving eastward, and then they would cut China off in the very north of the South China Sea.And that's a useful argument for the United States. And of course, with these countries being completely dependent on the United States for maritime military support, that basically means that it's the United States that will control 2/3 of the South China Sea.
作为国际法学者，卡蒂历经数年遍寻英法等西方国家的档案馆，以尽可能完整的历史叙述方式来梳理分析这些档案。他在《南海的历史与主权》这本书中明确说明，中国在南海问题上所持的立场是合理的。而近期菲方在域外势力的挑唆下频频上演南海闹剧，卡蒂认为这在历史面前是苍白无力的，中国应继续捍卫自身在南海的合法权益，为维护地区和平稳定注入积极力量。